Hello, Namaste. This is Abhishek Karti from Kathmandu, Nepal. And I would like to welcome you all for this training program and also my presentation on retrofitting vehicles in context of Nepal. And these are the contents of my presentation. And going through the introduction of the retrofitting vehicles, as Imos has already presented on retrofitting, and basically retrofitting is like a replacement of the combustion engine from the vehicle that goes under the conversion process, and with the electronic battery components like the motor, batteries, and powertrain components. And in this picture, we can see that like how are the vehicles being converted in Nepal with the replacement of the rear axle with the electric components. Moving to the historical background of Nepal, electric vehicle conversion is not a new thing in Nepal, and it started way back in 1993 with the diesel power Bikram Tempo, which was converted into Safari Tempo. In 1993, seven diesel powered three-wheel public vehicle, also known as Bikram Tempo, was converted into electric electric parts of a Tempo under the aid of USA. After the successful conversion of these five or seven diesel power vehicle Tempo into the Safari Tempo, five different companies started manufacturing Safari Tempo. Around 600 Safari Tempos were successfully manufactured, and they have been successfully running till date today. In 1994, Volkswagen Beetle car from Volkswagen was converted into EV by the EV development groups by the name of Vikas Pandey, Kiran Joshi, Sanjeev Bhandare, and Girish Pokhrel. It was the first conventional vehicle, private vehicle, that was electrified in Nepal, and it proved the possible potential of electrification in Nepal. But due to the lack of government policies, such converted vehicle couldn't run on the roads of Nepal. And even though the interest, due to which the interested customer who were willing to convert their vehicle, they couldn't move on to the conversion of the vehicle. And in 2004, Sikh Visionary converted the gasoline power Omni van into the electric vehicle, which also faced the similar kind of challenge in Nepal. Due to the policy and the standard, the vehicles could no more run on the streets of the Nepal. And these are the companies who are currently retrofitting the vehicles in Nepal. Sikh Visionary, it has maintained its legacy of retrofitting the vehicles in Nepal till date today. And the new company, Digo and Avanti Karmasala, they are into this business right now. So if we go toward the reason why we need to go to the electrification, firstly, we don't have the trash zone where in Nepal where we'll go for scrapping the old vehicles. And second, of course, this is the environment matter. We don't want vehicle emission, and we breathe the air, polluted air. And thirdly, better energy efficiency. We all know that electric vehicles in electric motor, they are highly efficient in transforming the energy that are stored in the form of the battery into the wheel. It converts almost 77% of the energy in the grid from the grid to the wheel, while comparing to the ICE power vehicle, they convert only from 13% to the 30%. And it creates an economic growth where there will be a lot of job placement, and the lower cost of the maintenance and the cost of the buying the fuels for the vehicles. And we go through the technical aspect of the vehicle conversion in Nepal. There are the three phases which we have been going through: the pre-conversion, conversion, and the post-conversion. In the pre-conversion, we plan for like removal of the ICE power components and its accessories that won't be required after the conversion. And we go for arrangement of the working space where in the lab or the workshop where the vehicle will be converted, and the arrangement of the tools which will be used for the vehicle conversion process. And during the conversion process, there will be a process like removing the engines and mounting of the electronic components and wire harness. Post conversion, it will go through the homologation process and the final finishing of the project. And And taking the summarizing the previous steps, we go through the vehicle scanning, through the train scanning devices, where through which we can determine whether the vehicle will be fit enough to go through the conversion or not. And secondly, we go for different simulations tool to size the different powertrain components, means like the motor and the batteries, as per the requirements for the vehicle to be converted. And moving to the next step, during the conversion, the engine and this relevant accessories will be removed from the vehicles. And secondly, the electronic vehicle component like motor, controls, and battery packs will be retrofitted into that vehicle. And finally, the vehicle will go through different kind of the engineering testing process for and to pass the homologation process. And the challenge of the retrofitting in Nepal is, of course, the standards and the government policy and the time frame, because there isn't any local company we sell the retrofitting companies in Nepal, so it has to be imported from the different country, from India, China, which will take some lead time from 3 months to 6 months. It will definitely, it's a long time to convert a single vehicle. And definitely in the future, there will be more new company that will, who will be providing the retrofitting companies in Nepal. In that case, lead time for the project can be minimized. And finally, before conclusion, what I would like to say that these are the vehicles that has been registered in the Nepal, which are up to 20 years old in Nepal. And if we consider only assuming that if only 20% of these vehicles are fitted for the retrofitting, then we still have 7,772 units of buses, 1,531 units of micro vehicles, and 38,170 cars, jeep and taxis. We saw the huge potential for the retrofitting vehicle in Nepal. And these are the resources that have used for preparing this presentation. And the final, I would like to say thank you. If there's any queries, I'm more than happy to share my knowledge with you all. Thank you.